Hello dear friends, today we are going to learn about the drying equipments. First, let us see the classification of the drying equipments. The drying equipments, they are classified as material agitated, in which the material gets agitated, and the second class is the class in which the material does not get agitated. The material agitated includes fluidized bed dryer, moving bed dryer, pneumatic dryer. The material not agitated includes static bed dryer, means stationary, and hence the material it does not get agitated. Again, the fluidized bed dryer, it is of two types: batch type, which includes vertical dryer, and continuous dryer, which includes horizontal vibrating conveyor dryer and vertical dryer. The moving bed dryer, it includes batch type of vacuum and tumble pan dryer. And continuous includes rotary, turbo tray, vibrating conveyor, tower and cascade, screw conveyor dryer. The pneumatic dryer, it contains continuous type, which its example is spray flash dryer. And static blade, again it is of two types, continuous type and batch type. In continuous type, there is tunnel dryer, belt dryer, festoon dryer, drum dryer. In batch type, there is tray and truck dryer, vacuum shelf dryer and freeze dryer. First, let us learn about tray dryers. So, it works on the principle that hot air is continuously circulated and there occurs forced convection there occurs heating to remove the moisture from the solids which is placed in the trays. Simultaneously, the moist air, it is removed partially. Now, first, let us see the construction. The construction of the tray dryer is as shown. It consists of a rectangular chamber whose walls are insulated from inner and outer sides. Then these are the trays. Okay. These are the trays. Okay. And they are placed inside the heating chambers. The number of trays, it varies, and also the size, it changes. The dryers of laboratory size may contain minimum of three trays, whereas dryers of the industry scale, they contain up to 20 trays. So each tray, we can say it is rectangular or it is square, and it is about 1.2 to 2.4 meters in square meter square in area. The distance between the bottom of upper tray and the upper surface of the next tray, okay, it has to be minimum 40 mm. So this distance, it has to be minimum 40 mm. So the trays, they are placed in the racks or wheels, okay, and these wheels, they can be rolled out or into the chamber. So dryer, there is a dryer, and it is this dryer is fitted with a fan for circulating the air over the trays. Also, these are the heaters. If you observe here, these are the heaters which are used to heat the air. Okay, so we can say it is electrically heated element. Okay, and it is provided inside to heat the air. In the corner of the chamber, direction vanes are placed, okay, and they direct the path of the air. Now let us see the working. So here there is the inlet for the air. So when the air, it will move in, okay, so this will move and it will be screened here, and because of the motion of this fan, the air will be circulated. Now, as the air is moving here, when it will come in this part, it is getting heated up, okay, and then it will flow all over the trays, and because of that, the air, it moves all over the trays, okay, and because of this circulation, because of this fan, the air is constantly moving, and hence there is no stagnant layer formation. Now, as the air, it will move along, on this tray we have kept our substance which we want to dry. This air, it will pick up the moisture from the substance, and the water, as the water will evaporate from the surface, it will diffuse by the capillary action. Okay, so these events, they occur in a single passage of the air. Okay, so the time of contact is short and the amount of water which gets picked up in a single pass is very small. Okay, so a discharge is provided at one end, okay, to discharge the air. Okay, so now this air, once it is moved, it comes out and it is taken off from this point. So this thing is continued, then again you are going to introduce the air, but only 10 to 20% of the fresh air is introduced, okay, and the moist air is discharged from the outlet. So the constant temperature and uniform flow, air flow over the material, it can be maintained for achieving uniform dry. Okay, so this is the principle and construction which we have already discussed, and it is very easy. The principle, construction and working is very easy. Now let us see the use. The sticky materials, plastic substances, granular mass or crystalline material, the precipitates and the paste, they can be dried in the dryer. So crude drugs, chemicals, powders, tablet granules or parts of the equipments, they are dried. What is the advantage of this equipment? In tray dryer, handling of the material, loading and unloading is can be done without losses. Tray dryer is operated batch wise. Batch drying is used extensively in the manufacturing of pharmaceuticals. Okay. Then what is the disadvantage? It requires more labor to load and unload, hence the cost of this equipment, it increases, and the process is very time consuming. Variants are available for this equipment, and one variant is tunnel dryer. Next, let us see the drum dryer, which is also known as roller dryer or film dryer. So the principle of this dryer is a heated hollow metal drum. It rotates on its longitudinal axis, which is partially dipped in the solution to be dried. The solution is carried as a film on the surface of the dryer, and it is dried to form a layer. Then using a suitable knife, okay, we remove the dried material while the drum is rotating. Okay, so we can say it is a continuous operation. Now let us see the construction. It consists of a horizontally mounted hollow steel drum, which is about 0.6 to 3 meters in diameter and 0.6 to 4 meters in length. Okay, the external surface of this hollow cylinder is smoothly polished. So below this drum, there is a feed tank, okay, or feed pan. Okay, and the arrangement of these two is in such a way that half mount, half of the drum is dip into this feed. Okay, so on one side of the drum, a spreader is placed. Now this is the spreader, this is the feed pan, this is the spreader. Okay, the role of this spreader is to spread all over to make a thin film of this feed on this surface. Okay, this is the heated drum and this is the doctor knife, and this doctor knife is placed here to remove the material or to scrape off the material. Okay, so here below this doctor knife, a storage bin is placed for collecting the knife to collect the material. Okay, now working, let us see. First, steam is passed inside this drum. Okay, so it gets heated up. So heat transfer coefficient, it has to be high, and drying capacity is directly proportional to the surface area of the drum. Larger is the surface area, more is the drying capacity. Okay, so heat is transferred by conduction to the material. So this steam will give its heat to this metal wall, and from here it will be given off to the material. Okay, also now the drum, it will be rotating. It performs 1 to 10 revolutions per minute. Okay, now as the drum is rotating, this drum, it picks up the feed from here, and because of the heat or conduction of heat, this feed, it gets dried up. Okay, so this is the liquid film and this is the dried feed. Okay, now this dried feed is removed from this doctor knife, and then this feed it forms into the storage tank. So the time of contact of the material with the hot metal is 6 to 15 seconds only. So therefore, the processing conditions such as film thickness, steam temperature, they have to be controlled. Okay, so in this thing, in this operation, heat transfer by conduction is very, very important. Okay, so now let us see the use of drum dryer. It is used for drying of the solutions, slurries, suspensions, etc. The products dried are milk products, starch products, ferrous salts, suspensions of zinc oxide, suspension of kaolin, yeast, pigments, salt extracts, antibiotics, granular extracts, insecticides, DDT, calcium, barium carbonates, and etc. Now, what is the advantage of it? In drum drying, drying time is less, only few seconds. Thus, heat sensitive material, they can be dried. The drum dryer, it occupies less space, okay, as it is compact. The product obtained is completely dry because of formation of a thin film. Okay, what is the disadvantage? Maintenance cost of the drum is very high. Then you have to be skilled to perform the operation, because you have to control the feeding rate, film thickness, speed of rotation, and temperature. Also, it is not suitable for salts with less solubility. Its variant are also available. Now let us see, or let us learn about fluidized bed dryer. The principle of fluidized bed dryer is hot air or gas is passed at high pressure through a perforated bottom of the container containing the granules which are to be dried. Okay, now we can say this is the container. Okay, it is a perforated container, and from here hot air is passed. Okay, now because we are passing hot air, this material gets lifted up from the bottom and it remains suspended in the stream of air, and this condition is called as fluidized state. Okay, now because of that fluidized state, the material, it gets it is circulated. Okay, it is covered from all sides with the hot air or hot gas, and due to that there occurs efficient heating, and hence it results into complete drying. Okay, so here the material or the granules, they are uniformly dried. First let us see the construction. You can have vertical fluid dryer, or you can have horizontal fluid bed dryer. Okay, so basically this dryer, it is made up of stainless steel or plastic, and it is fixed with this detachable bowl, and this bowl has a perforated bottom. Okay, this perforation, this bowl is used for charging and discharging. Okay, so this is an inlet which is provided for the air to move in, and this is the outlet for the air to pass out. Okay, so here this is the circulation control. These are the air heaters. Okay, also a pre-filter is mounted here, and the air, it becomes hot because of this heaters. Okay, now what happened, and this is the fan. This fan is situated, or it is placed in the upper part for circulating the hot air. Also back filters are placed, okay, above this drying bowl or detachable bowl, and this use of these back filters is a recovery of the fines. Okay, now let us see the working. The wet granules which are to be dried, they are placed in this detachable bowl. The bowl is pushed inside this dryer, and fresh air is allowed to move in from this inlet. Okay, as this air, it will pass through this pre-filters and heaters, it will get heated up. Okay, now the hot air, it flows to the bottom of the bowl, and simultaneously the fan is made to rotate. Okay, the air velocity, it increases. Now when the velocity of the air is greater than settling velocity of these particles, the granules, they become suspended in the gas stream. After some time, a point of pressure is reached at which the frictional drag of the particles is equal to the force of gravity. the granules, they rise in the container because of high velocity of the gas, and later they will fall back in a random boiling motion. So this condition is called as the fluidized state. The gas, as it surrounds every granule to completely dry, the air leaves the dryer by passing through this back filters. Okay, now these molecules, they are fluidized, and the air, it will leave through this bags. Okay, and the entrained particles, they get adhered to these bags. Okay, so these bags, they are periodically shaken to remove the entrained particles. Okay, so because of the intense mixing between the granules and the hot gas, there occurs uniform conditions of temperature, composition, and particle size distribution. So drying is achieved at a constant rate, and falling rate period is very short. Now the residence, this air, it is removed from this outlet. The residence time of the drying is about 40 minutes. The material is left for some time in the dryer for reaching the ambient temperature, and then the bowl is taken out and the material is removed. Okay. So this is the basic principle. Because of the hot air, the material, it gets fluidized, and we can dry the products. Okay. So construction and working we have already seen. Now let us see the pharmaceutical application of this fluidized bed dryer. It is popularly used for drying of granules in the production of tablets. It is used in many operations such as mixing, granulation, and drying. It is modified for coating of the granules as well. What is the advantage of this equipment? It takes very less time to complete the drying, that is 20 to 40 minutes. Then the drying containers are mobile, making handling simple, and labor cost is reduced. The thermal efficiency is 2 to 6 times greater than the tray dryer. It is also used for mixing the ingredients, and its mixing efficiency is also very high. Hot spots are not observed in the dryer because of its excellent mixing and drying capacities. Higher drying temperatures can be used that are not possible in tray dryer. And lastly, it facilitates the drying of the thermolabile substances. It can be used for batch type or continuous type of operation. It has a high output from small floor space. What is the disadvantage? Many organic powders, they develop electrostatic forces during drying, and earthing is very essential. The turbulence of the fluidized state of the granules may cause attrition of some material, resulting in production of fines. Now we will learn about spray dryer. The principle of spray dryer is that the fluid which is to be dried is atomized into fine droplets, which are thrown radially into a stream of moving hot gas. The temperature of the droplets is immediately increased, and fine droplets gets dried instantaneously in the form of spherical particles. So this process completes in a few seconds before the droplets reach the wall of the dryer. The working is that it is of two steps. First, there is atomization to form liquid droplets. The feed is introduced through the atomizer either by gravity or by using suitable pump to form fine droplets. The properties of the final product, it depend on the droplet form. Hence, selection of type of atomizer is very important. Okay. The next step is drying of the liquid droplets. The fine droplets, they are dried in the drying chamber by supplying the hot air through the inlet. And then we recover the dried product. Okay. So here, first, the feed is introduced through the atomizer either by gravity or by using suitable pump to form fine particles. These droplets of the final product, they depend on the droplet size of the, and hence it ultimately depends on the atomizer. Atomizer can be of any type. The rate of feed is adjusted so that droplet should not completely dry before reaching the wall of the drying chamber. Then there occurs drying of the droplets, okay, by supplying hot air. The surface of the liquid drop is dried immediately to form a tough shell. Further, the liquid inside, it must escape by diffusing through the shell at a particular rate. So at the same time, heat transfer from outside to inside take place by a rate greater than the liquid diffusion rate, and due to this heat inside mounts up and which allow the liquid to evaporate at a very faster rate. So this tendency of the liquid leads to rise in the internal pressure, which causes the droplets to swell. The shell's thickness decreases, whereas permeability for vapor increases. If the shell is neither elastic nor permeable, it ruptures and internal pressure it escapes. So the pressure temperature of the air is adjusted in such a way that the droplets should completely dry before reaching the walls of the dry chamber. Then there is final step of recovery of the dried product. So centrifugal force of atomizer drives the droplet to follow a helical path. The particles are dried during the journey and they finally fall into the conical bottom. Okay, so this process, it gets completed in a few seconds. The particle size of the final product, it ranges from 2 to 500 mm. Okay, so the construction involves, so this is the tangential air inlet, this is the hot air inlet, this is the gas outlet tube, this is the liquid inlet, and your atomizer is placed. Okay, this is the drying chamber, this is the conical section, this is the region from which vapor escapes. Then cyclone separator is placed here, and ultimately you get the product. Okay, now this, it moves inside and then it passes into the cyclone separator, and hence we get the product separated. The use of it is used for it gives better results than other dryers. The quantity of the material is large. The product, it can be used for thermolabile hygroscopic material as well. Okay, and the material which undergoes chemical decomposition. Now, what is the advantage of this? It is a continuous process and drying is rapid. Labor cost is low as it combines the function of evaporator, crystallizer, a dryer, a size reduction unit, and a classifier. So, by using atomizer, product of uniform and controllable size, it can be obtained. So, fine droplets provide large surface area. So, product shows excellent solubility and it's so very suitable for drying of the sterile products. The final product is ready directly for packing, and globules of the emulsions, they can be dried easily. What is the disadvantage of this? It is a bulky and expensive equipment, and it is not easy to operate and clean as well. So this was all about the equipments. Thank you for watching.